The King's Avatar, Chapter 1142, A Nervous Rookie, Audio Source, WuxiaWorldAudiobook.com. Chapter 1142, A Nervous Rookie. Translator, Nomiami. Editor, Nomiami. Yi Xiu was the first one to walk onto the stage for Happy. Pan Lin was not the only one who was shocked. Everyone in the stadium, including the players from Team 100 Blossoms, were astonished. According to the usual practices, the ace player would appear in the group arena to fight for the 2 points. The ace player rarely appeared in the individual competition. With Happy's arrangements, was Happy giving up on the group arena, targeting the 3 points in the individual competition? There was no need to dwell on this thought. The list of names for the matches was set before the game. Zheng Xinran from Team 100 Blossoms went on stage for this away game. Who was Zheng Xinran? Before this match, no one knew. He was a rookie promoted from the 100 Blossoms training camp this season. When his name was submitted to the league in the new season's players list, it could be considered as his first public appearance in the circle. After that, he appeared Esport Home's September 1st edition, introducing the team rosters for the Alliance's 20 teams. All officially registered appeared in this list. Important transfers would have short introductions, but Zheng Xinran only had his name listed and popped up on 100 Blossoms team roster just like this. No press conference had been convened for him, so no reporters thought about interviewing him. He was not a rookie who had gained the adoration of millions, but the team gave him a chance because of his skill. He became an official player and waited for the chance to appear on stage. Then, he would use his play to earn a name for himself in the league. 100 Blossom didn't send him up for the opening match, so he sat idly on the bench. However, he wasn't annoyed. Unless he was one of those so-called heavenly talents, this was something almost all rookies had to experience, even more so in Team 100 Blossoms. They had watched his player came out of their training camp, sign a contract with them, and sit on the bench. He found opportunities here and there. He gradually became a part of the main roster, then the core of the team, then a god in the Alliance. Tang Hao. For every rookie sitting on the benches, there was nothing more encouraging than Tang Hao's story. Zheng Xinran inherited Delillo, the brawler account Tang Hao left behind when he left 100 Blossoms. He promised himself that he would be like Tang Hao and conquer the world, starting from the bench. He was able to get a chance to fight in their second round. For someone who knew Tang Hao's story very well, he knew that he had gained an opportunity even earlier than Tang Hao. This fact raised his spirits. He was moved and excited and didn't even sleep well last night. He could finally step onto the stage. Unfortunately, his opponent just had to be Yi Xiu. Who didn't know of Yi Xiu's accomplishments in the early days? New rookies didn't feel too pressured facing him though. This was because that era of glory was too far in the past. Only players who had played glory for over 10 years had the chance to personally witness that era. Zheng Xinyan obviously hadn't played glory for that long. By the time he started playing glory and entered 100 Blossoms training camp, Yi Xiu had already been labeled as outdated. Not long afterwards, he retired. When he returned, excellent era disbanded. Zheng Xinran indeed admired the amount of commotion this god could make, but he only started to learn about Yi Xiu's skill when his team was preparing to fight Happy. Like everyone else, he only knew about the unspecialized and the myriad manifestations umbrella in theory, but not much in actual practice. Team 100 Blossoms had been distressed for this very reason. However, Zheng Xinran was relatively at ease because he didn't think he would have the opportunity to fight Yi Xiu. He would be appearing in the individual competition, so the team competition was irrelevant. He didn't expect to meet Happy's core and god in the individual competition. However, what he didn't think would happen happened. He was a rookie who would playing in his first competitive match in his professional career. Unfortunately, he just had to face a god who had fought hundreds of battles. The thunderous applause given to Yi Xu in the stadium caused half of Zheng Xinran's body to go numb. He realized that competition wasn't as simple as he had imagined. Why did he feel so suffocated in such a big stadium? Happy was a new team that had only recently entered the league, yet they already had so many fans. So noisy. Zheng Xinran entered the player booth. The player booth was completely cut off from the outside world. However, his brain was still in a mess. The amount of noise and the feeling of suffocation lingered in his mind, and he was unable to wipe it away. 1 minute had passed. Yi Xu pressed ready after logging on with Lord Grimm and Zhou in the arena room. However, there was no sign of activity from Zheng Xinran. What happened? The crowd became restless, so the referee immediately took action to see what was up with Zheng Xinran. Then, he saw a player whose body was completely rigid and tense. It was pressure. The referee was experienced and this wasn't the first time he had encountered such a situation. He only needed to glance at the player to tell that he was too nervous. Are you ready? The referee sighed and knew the player was definitely not prepared, but the match couldn't give him limitless time to prepare. He could only confirm with this method. If he was ready, then the match would start at once. If not, then he would forfeit. Zheng Xinran obviously knew the rules, so he immediately nodded. Under the guidance of the referee, he logged on, entered the room with his character, and pressed ready. They soon reached the end of the countdown. Both Lord Grimm and DeLillo loaded into the map. DeLillo was the character Tang Hao had previously used. When he had been present, 100 Blossoms made an effort to upgrade it. But after his departure, 100 Blossom went back to their old Berserker and Spitfire combo. DeLillo was no longer an account the club focused on. After the level 75 update, DeLillo naturally wasn't a priority. Now that the account had been handed down to a rookie, the majority of the equipment was still as Tang Hao had left it. Upgrades in the equipment were made through upgraded level 75 orange equipment instead of upgraded level 75 silver equipment. In comparison, Happy's character weakness wasn't so obvious before DeLillo. Lord Grimm's Myriad Manifestation Umbrella was at level 70. Even though he didn't have any other silver equipment, a full set of level 75 orange equipment was enough to compare with silver equipment at level 70. As for character player suitability, in reality, only the powerhouses had the resources to be so picky. The moment Yi Xu entered the room, he had Lord Grimm sprint AEAD. As for Zheng Xinran, he was still in a daze. He didn't do anything and was still trying to sort out his emotions. The audience didn't know about Zheng Xinran's situation. All they saw was that the old general was charging forward impatiently, while the rookie Calmy stood his ground. Had those two switched accounts? The audience didn't know about Zheng Xinran's situation, neither did Yi Xu. Yi Xu didn't have any way to learn about such a new rookie, so he could only learn as the match progressed. However, when Lord Grimm reached the center of the map, he didn't see his opponent. Is he moving strategically? For any pro player, this observation was instinctive. Yi Xu immediately looked over the terrain. This was a home game for Happy, so they picked the map themselves. Even if he closed his eyes, he wouldn't walk the wrong way on this map. He immediately took note of any locations that were possible for a sneak attack, but he couldn't sense any movement from the opponent. Is he playing dirty? WuxiaWorldAudio.com. Yi Xu wondered. The brawler was a class that could play dirty, so Yi Xu took caution and carefully looked around. He had Lord Grimm move AEAD while deliberately making mistakes. No response. Zheng Xin ran from Hundred Blossom, was still trying to regain his composure at the spawn point, so he hadn't moved. Even if the audience watched from a bird's eye view, none of them knew what was happening. Those who had watched Happy's matches in the Challenger League sent glacés towards Wei Chen at Happy's bench. Playing dirty by standing at the spawn point was similar to this old player. Happy had once used this tactic against their opponents. Was this retribution for Happy? If this was the Challenger League, the audience might have been a bit excited, but this was different. This was an official league match, as well as a home game for Happy. Even though their popularity couldn't be compared with the early years of Excellent Era, it was definitely enough for the bottom-tier and mid-tier teams to be jealous of. Having a large audience meant that a lot of people bought tickets. This was probably where teams earn most of their day-to-day income from. At this home game, Happy's fans started to feel a little worried. They were afraid of the strange moves this foreign rookie from Hundred Blossoms would make. The atmosphere in the stadium started to grow heavy. Everyone watched Lord Grimm gradually get closer to DeLillo while the latter was calm as always. At last, the two characters appeared in each other's view. Ye Zhu saw DeLillo, and Zheng Xin Ran saw Lord Grimm. After that, DeLillo charged forward. He sprinted straight without showing any signs of turning. There was no touch of tactics as he advanced straight AEAD as if this was the deciding point. He must be scheming something. The audience thought to themselves. If this were really the deciding point in the match, what was he doing earlier? Was he just standing there to nurture his strength while exhausting the enemy? Frankly speaking, that wasn't possible in Glory. Many players would do random ineffective actions before they encountered their opponent as warm-up. There must be some sort of scheme within all this for Zheng Xin Ran to just wait there doing nothing. It was just like what Wei Chen had done at Happy. The audience didn't have time to think any further because the two had started fighting already. Hundred Blossoms Zheng Xin Ran, a schemer in everyone's minds, was sent flying backgrounds in the first exchange. The audience was stunned, and Ye Zhu was also a bit astonished. He had been 120% careful, and had numerous variations and follow-ups prepared after Falling Flower Palm, but it turned out that Falling Flower Palm was all it took to send him flying away. As for his follow-up, Lord Grimm missed when he struck with his spear. This was a rare mistake for veterans like Ye Zhu. It was simply because that palm hitting was too surprising. The moment DeLillo was about to reach the ground after being blown away, his body twitched and he lay flat on the ground. What is he doing? Ye Zhu was dumbstruck. To even fail to quick recover, was he really a pro player? Even Ye Zhu was slightly dazed. He was playing in a pro match, right? He wasn't in the arena or the Challenger League, torturing scrubs, right? Is it a trap? Ye Zhu didn't move forward and instead used long-range skills. After a chain of ferocious attacks, his heart finally steadied. It was impossible for this to be trap. If it was, then this was way overboard. The player before him was simply playing really bad for some reason. Lord Grimm rushed forward without any hesitation. He dispatched his opponent cleanly and won. The audience was dumbstruck. They even forgot to applaud and cheer for their team. What happened? This victory was too simple. Was Hundred Blossoms deliberately playing badly? End chapter.